Okay. Many students still are asking this question, what should I write in my planner? So this is a video for students and parents just to really understand what should be in the planner and what to write in your planner if you aren't already using it on a regular basis. So every day you should write what you did in class. So what you worked on for language, it could have been a literature circle, it could have been a skill, it could have been writing, but you're going to write what you spent your time doing in class. And then in that same box, you're going to write in what you need to do for homework that day. Remember, you should only have homework in language and math, okay? If you use your humanities and your science work time wisely, you should not have homework in Spanish. All of the work should ideally be done in class as well. And the final thing that should be in your planner are your upcoming due dates. So any work, we decide due dates at the start of the cycle, and any work that you have, you should set your due date, and sometimes those are set for you by the teachers. But then you should go ahead and put that due date in the planner and make sure that you say that it's due on that day. So that doesn't mean you're working on it that day. That means you're handing it in on that day. So here's just a quick example of a planner and what that looks like. Notice language arts is kind of the first column, and I have what I did in class that day and what my homework is for each of those days. And you can see that I highlighted my due dates in yellow. I think that would be very helpful. For reading, I added the pages that were read or needed to be read for those literature circles, and I put little check boxes just so I could check it off when it's finished. You can just cross it off, whatever works best for you. And then humanities is kind of the same format. Notice I divided up with individual work and group work, and there's no homework column because ideally if you're getting your work done during individual and group work time, you wouldn't have homework. This is the vocabulary retake, and I highlighted that in pink because it was just an assessment that I was retaking. And then notice that science is kind of squiggled out because in this trimester, I didn't have, this half of the trimester, I didn't have science, but then it'll flip flop with humanities. And then math is pretty consistent. I put 30 minutes for homework, but you can be more specific there. And I actually think that Doug and Heather would prefer you to be more specific and say what section you're working on and then grade that section. So this, for the furthest column, is for student comments and parent initials. So if you parents are initialing, that's kind of the space to do that. And then there's also a space at the bottom for homework on the weekend that you can use that space as well. And these are just extra boxes, so you can kind of take notes in there for whatever you need throughout the week as well. So this is what your planner should look like when it's fully filled out after a week. A week's worth of work. And parents, if you have questions on what that should look like and everything that should go in your planner, please don't hesitate to reach out to us and let us know. Thank you.